The Media Effects Lab is a facility designed to give researchers an opportunity to learn about the psychological impacts of various media formats as well as content. Where this facility comes in is that it allows them the opportunity to examine responses that they may not be able to get from a paper, pencil, or online questionnaire. We have features and capabilities that allow researchers to understand and examine responses that participants may not be able to readily articulate. We're able to examine explicit as well as implicit attitudes. So those implicit attitudes are those unconscious thoughts and feelings that people may try to filter when they're given a piece of paper to answer on. And so we have computers here that can track how long it takes a person to respond to a particular question, and we can better tell whether or not they're filtering their responses or if their actual response or feeling or thought about a particular issue. We can also record heart rate activity and facial muscle contractions as indicators of emotional responses. If a person's brow furrows, that may be an indicator of frowning. If their heart rate slows down, that could be an indicator of sadness, or it could also be an indicator of increased attention levels to a particular piece of media that's being presented to them.
The eye tracking equipment has really aided in my research. It allows me to look more closely at different kinds of sponsorships and branded communications.
50% of the studies are being run by graduate students. They aren't participants, they aren't assistants, it's their own individual or group level research projects. And so it provides them an opportunity to get their hands dirty as far as research is concerned, and it also allows for them the opportunity to conduct their own research efforts and design their studies from scratch all the way from beginning to data analysis and completion. In the fall semester, we brought a group of undergraduate and graduate students into the Manship School's forum and recorded their heart rate activity as they watched the LSU Mississippi State football game. So we were able to see how their heart rate decreased and also increased as indicators of intention or increased excitement as LSU performed or made big plays. And we were able to see that heart rate activity increased when LSU had major offensive plays, major defensive plays. We were also able to see that heart rate activity increased as crowd noise increased. And so we would take that type of information and convey that potentially to an advertiser and advise them to ask for sponsorship opportunities when the crowd noise increased, because that could be an indicator of increased attention to the screen and a greater likelihood of them seeing the sponsorship appear on the screen as well.